is Candace Kinser, the Chief Executive of the New Zealand Technology Industry Association. Hi, Candace.
Hello.
You're an American yourself, and how does one end up in New Zealand?
I am. I moved here nearly 17 years ago, originally from Austin, Texas, went to university in Hawaii, and came down just for a 1 year or a 2 year working visa and a visit, and loved it so much I ended up staying. Over the course of those years, I've worked for some high-profile multinationals, Sun Microsystems back in the day, telecom, and I've also started a number of my own technology companies that have been quite successful as well.
Give us a sense of the size and the growth of the technology sector in New Zealand at the moment.
Sure. The technology sector at the moment is third in terms of its contribution to New Zealand's economy. In first place is the dairy industry, which is well known worldwide for being one of the biggest and best globally. In second place is tourism, and I know that sounds a bit strange, but tourism is counted as a major income generator for New Zealand. And in third place is technology, and that includes software, hardware, robotics, high-tech engineering, and manufacturing. But it's also the fastest growing industry by nearly 16.5% compounded annual growth rate per year. If you follow those calculations through, it will be the largest industry for New Zealand by 2020, which bodes really well for everybody who's in the sector. But it's also one of the crunch points in terms of trying to generate that growth, but not having enough people in the country to actually ensure that we can get there. So that's one of the reasons why we're very keen to bring down people who are interested in contributing not only their skills, but also learning a lot about this beautiful country and having opportunities of a lifetime.
So Candace, also, this is a country that is used by multinationals around the world to test markets, because New Zealanders do like to take up new technology ideas, don't they?
They absolutely do. And one of the interesting things that not many people know about is organizations like McDonald's and Facebook actually come down to New Zealand and launch concepts into this marketplace. For a number of reasons, one of which is the diversity of cultures. Over half of Auckland's population is from somewhere else, an immigrant outside of New Zealand. We also have a tendency here to try new ideas and provide feedback, positive or negative, on an easy basis. So where you may have some questions about, do you like this or do you like that? Kiwis in particular will give you feedback at face value.
Candace, thank you very much for joining us today.
Sure. Thank you for having me.